Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Next Level Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and in this particular video I'll be talking about linear regression. We'll be solving a linear regression project in reality. In previous video we have past few videos I have clearly explained what linear regression is, how to calculate the slope and the coefficient values and the intercept and all that, and how to get the trend line, and here we'll be discussing how to do that with the help of Python programming language. So if you haven't watched that video, you can go ahead and click on the I icon on the top right hand side corner of your screen and you'll be directed to those videos. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe our channel if you like it, and also press the bell icon if you haven't already, because once we upload any video you'll be posted. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So for this particular project, I'm going to import pandas, numpy, matplotlib for visualization, seaborn also for visualization. Also we'll be using this particular expression of codes, which is percentage matplotlib inline, which helps us keep the plot within the parameters of this graph. We'll be using USA housing data, which is a very famous data on of Python or say any other language as well. This can be found in Kaggle and this can also be found on GitHub if you want to use this particular data. We are storing this the data by using read_csv in USA housing, and by looking at the first five rows and all the columns, we see that we have average income of that of the person who has been taking the household. We have average area of the house, average area of the house age. We have area number of rooms. We have number of rooms in terms of areas. We have average area number of bedrooms, area population wherever that the place is, and price of the data, and we have the address as well. Now here we can see that the y value or the dependent variable has to be the price. So based on this particular columns, what should be the price of this particular column, that is what we want to predict in this data. So here I'm using USA housing info method to just see what my data looks like. So we have 5000 entries, and that is number of rows are 5000, and we have number of columns as seven columns. Area income, area house age, which is there is no null value here in this particular data, so we are not going to face any problem of missing data. So we that's that. Now when we see that, when we use describe method, we see that the columns are we see the count is this and the mean value is this, standard deviation, minimum value, 25% of my data, what 25% of my data looks like, what my 50% of the data looks like, 75%, and maximum value is what in each column. Now here the string column has been has not been into consideration because it only takes the numerical values, because we have these aggregative methods here. If you want, you can go ahead and include all parameter to just include the string column as well. Now to see what is the name of the columns, and in case there are spaces in the column name while writing that, we use USA housing.columns, and for exploratory data analysis we are using sns.pairplot_housing. So a pair plot, what it does, it gives you a correlation kind of a plot correlation of each column with the other and with itself. So we have on diagonals we have histograms, and on otherwise we have this kind of a data. So average income is related to price here, and we see that area of the house age is also related to the price here, because we see an upward movement here, and Yeah, so we can derive a lot of conclusions from this particular data, this particular matrix as well. Now, distribution plot. For distribution plot, we want to see that if whether my price data is normally distributed or not. So here I'm using SNS.dist plot and using USA housing column price to see the distribution of the data. It looks normally distributed. Now, when I say normally distributed, I basically mean that the mean, median, and mode are same or approximately same, and my data is forming a bell-shaped curve here. So we can see both the things happening. So we can say that the data is normally distributed. Now we can also use a heat map method in the SNS plot to see the and include the correlation of the entire data, and with the help of that we'll be able to see the columns and the rows. We'll be able to see the correlation between each column and so on and so forth. If the values are zero or the area is black, that means there is no correlation. Otherwise, it is a positive correlation. So we see that the data has its positive correlation with itself. Apart from that, the correlation can be seen where price are with area income, the correlation is good, and we have slightly correlated data with the number of bedrooms and the number of bedrooms and the number of rooms here, and so on and so forth. So heat map method can be used to see the correlation in this format as well. Now when I say correlation, I basically mean that Carl Pearson's correlation method, not Spearman's correlation. Now to build our linear regression model, what we can do is we can separate each column, that is the housing and the price, that is X data independent and the dependent data, separate them to manually, or do it we have to do it technically manually, but yeah, we can either do it like this, or we can just use the indexes method, that is extracting the column method and slicing operator to extract the same. Now if I want to split the data into train and test, because I want the model to not be able to see the averages and the standard deviation of the entire data, so that the predictions become more overfitted, we don't want that. So in that case, what we want to do is that we are using train and test method. Now again, train and test is split by 40% of the data is going to be my test size, so here, and the random state is 0.01, it can be anything. Now importing the linear regression method, from the linear regression model we have linear regression LM, and we are going to fit the train data on this LMM model and fit that as well. And once we fit that, we see that the intercept is minus this value, and the if you want to see the coefficients of all the columns, what is the slope value in relation with y in particular, we can just go ahead and use pt.dataframe LM coefficient underscore x dot columns, and columns equals to coefficient, the column name is coefficient, and we have this data, and the data is being used, this particular data is being used to create a data frame here. So we have this kind of a coefficient going on here. Now what we want to do is that we want to predict the values as well. So here we have predictions here in predictions column, and we are going to find the scattered plot. We are using the scatter plot method, y underscore test comma predictions, to see how my predictions are, and we see that they are almost the same. Now if we want to create a residual histogram, what we can do is we can create it by using the dist plot method, and y test minus the predictions will give you the residual plot as well. And the bins which we are using is 50. Distribution plot gives us the line as well. If you want, you can use a histogram instead, and then plot the KDE on top of that. If you want, by default the KDE is here, and if you don't want it, just press shift tab and falsify the KDE parameter inside. Now if I talk about how to see how to justify if the my model, we can use any method and see if the error is and see if there is not much of an error. So so for that, what we can do is, in between the prediction values and the observed values, we can use mean absolute error method, and with that we will be able to see the difference, the error. But in mean absolute error, there the values are in absolute form with no negative signs, so we don't get the negative signs in this case. If you want, we can use mean squared error method, which will give you the squared error. Again, minus sign will be removed and we get the square of the original error. But if we want the exact error, on an average how much the error is of the data, we can use this particular formula, where in we under root the entire error which we are about to find out, and that's that. So these are three methods which we can use to see what the prediction errors are, and we see that the values state that this much is the error value of here. And we can use matrix method, where matrix method or library in particular, which is in again sklearn, and we can call out mean absolute error for calculating mean absolute method y underscore test predictions. We can also use mean squared underscore error for y test underscore prediction error, and we can use np.sqrt mean square root error sqrt method to square root the original value, so that we get this result. This is your first real machine learning project. Congrats on helping your neighbor out. So yeah, that's that. This is how we do the linear regression in Python programming language. We can obviously have a lot more things we can do on this particular data as well. We can change, we can standardize the entire data, we can change the, or we can normalize the data, or we can put this in multiple ranges here. We can bring this data into a range, but in particular, because if we see let's see where my, let's see that here we have the income, and the mean of income is different, and they are being measured on a different scale, so there might be a chance that our predictions are in reality and are not perfect, and if we change the data, that might also change the result, and the error might increase. So if we haven't standardized and scaled this particular data, so we can also do that. And for that to happen, if you want to learn about how to standardize and how to rescale the data in machine learning and in linear regression in particular, you have to wait for our next video. Also if you want to learn more about DexLab Analytics, or more about machine learning and linear regression, or you want to learn in particular anything like that, you can contact us on these numbers given on the screen, or you can reach out to us via mail by writing on hello@texlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. If you want you can visit our website and check what we teach and what we preach here. So I hope that you like this video. If you haven't already, please click on the like button, subscribe us, and press on the bell icon again, bell icon, so that you are notified each time we update a video here. Just have fun, keep learning, and take care.